Hello everyone, this is me Sadia here and I'm doing your special message reading for the sign of Aquarius. So let's see what's coming up for the sign of Aquarius for the month of March. Let's see what the universe has to say to you in order to make things easy for you. Whatever the message that comes through today in this reading is going to help you in one way or the other to clear the path for you towards your dreams and goals. And to have a life of your wishes fulfilled. So let's see. The messages that that's gonna show up during this reading can be applicable in your love life as well as your home life. And in fact, they can be, you know, applicable in any area of your life. Just pick whatever resonates and leave the rest. Because these are general readings, it may and it may not resonate with everyone out there. So yeah. To get a personal reading, you can reach out to me for that on my email ID in the description box. You can also follow me on Instagram where I do daily readings. So let's see what the universe wants to communicate to you through me. So you could have a wish fulfilled life in the month of March. Let's see what are the messages coming from the universe to you. I pulled out one card from the miracle cards. I will pull two cards from the right away deck. So let's see what are the messages that universe wants you to know. That it's more like, you know, universe is going to tell you how to work certain things to, you know, get things rolling on for you in whatever area it applies to in your life. So yeah, let's see. I will begin with the miracle card. Let's see what it has to say, what the message is coming through from the universe for you in the month of March. Let go of the painful past and envy. Release all blocked emotions. Increase your knowledge and focus on a specialized profession. I think it's high time that you let go of whatever was blocking you in the past. It could be an ex, it could be your connection or your you know, pull towards an ex. It could be your whatever that is basically holding you from moving on in your life. You need to let go of that. And yeah, once you, you know, just disconnect the cords that are still, you know, the cords that are still binding you with that past of yours, which was painful. Obviously, if you want to walk away from something, it must be something that you don't like. Otherwise, you would always want to stay connected to that. But if it was not painful or it was not negative in any way, you would never wish to walk away from that. So whatever that is basically holding you from growth, or which is basically stopping you from growth, you need to let go of that. You are well supported by both the guardian angel and the protection angel. Healer, this card has great reserves of energy. The card has uncontrollable energy. It's more like, you know, if you leave the past, if you walk into the future with no strings attached to the past, you have to have faith in the universe that universe is going to be supporting you throughout your journey from this onwards. And you need to let go of past, because whatever that is basically connecting you to past is bringing blocks in your life. It's more like self-imposed blocks that I feel are there for you in the month of March. You have to it's more like the only way to overcome or to, you know, get your path cleared is by releasing or cutting ties with the past. Because I believe whatever the energy the past is bringing in your life right now is only destructive. You can, you know, use this energy to work in a constructive method for you is you walking away from it, cutting ties from it, leaving the past behind. Stop thinking negative. release all the blocked emotions. Like, you know, try to cleanse your chakras, because that is going to be very important. If you cannot heal from the past, you cannot move ahead. And that's why it's like, you know, the universe is asking you to cleanse your energy so you could move ahead. The positive healing light will bring you strength and help you choose the right path. Happiness and zest will enter your life. Be conscious and do away with negative feelings like envy, jealousy, and hatred. If you have anybody in your past, anybody from your past who is, you know, who makes you get anger, who makes you hate you, or who makes you hate that particular person, just let go of all those negative emotions, because start thinking from a different perspective. You need to do that, and to do that, you have to heal from your past. And you could meditate, you could do breathing exercises as well to let go of the fears of let go of the anger. Just try to surround yourself with the positive people, with the people who value you, with the people who love you, with the people who can add beauty to your life, rather than being with the wrong people or staying stuck in a situation where people talk about your past and make you feel even worse. So try to, you know, if you have people around you who are basically, you know, telling you, I got so upset hearing about your past, maybe if you broke up, maybe if you just divorced from your husband or wife, don't talk to such people, or try to avoid meeting such people if necessary, to avoid those kind of communication. I would suggest you to spend some time alone, like go on a holiday alone, so you could recharge yourself, because that's the need of the hour, I would say. Because if you cannot heal from the past, if you cannot, you know, get done with the negative emotions that your past is bringing in your life right now, you will not be able to move on. So you really need to heal from that. A period of struggle will come to an end, but definitely you need guidance on that. So it's more like, you know, you might have to cut ties with a few people in your life so you could fully heal from your current situation or from your past. Include a daily regime of exercise, yoga, or morning walks in your life. Look after yourself and improve your diet by including bioenergy foods. Increase your knowledge and focus on the specialized profession. You could also get yourself busy in, learning skills of some sort, whatever you are interested in. If you're interested in the, occult sciences, you can choose that path. If you are interested in, you know, whatever field you are connected to, you can, you know, work, get yourself some sort of admission in any institute which is offering the certain courses that you can, you know, apply to in order to specialize in your profession. Because the more you stay busy, the more you stay away from the negative people, the sooner you would be able to heal yourself from whatever that was negative in your past, which is basically spoiling things for you in your current situation. Knight of Cups and the King of Cups. Here, like, you know, the universe is asking you to stop you to accept any love offer coming your way until and unless you have gained your emotional strength back. Because with the Knight of Cups, this is how you are right now. If you accept any love offer coming your way during this time, you would not be able to do justice to that person. Neither you would be able to do justice to you, because you need to heal from your past first before you could say yes or get into a new relationship. So you need to be in control of your emotions first. And for that, you definitely need to work on your past hurt, which you need to come out of. Cleanse yourself, cleanse your energies, remove the negativity around you, remove the people who make you feel bad about you. Just love yourself more and release all the negativity, blockages. Do things that make you happy, because that's going to set the theme for the month or for your life, I would say. It's like, you know, you need to set that as a theme of the month where you have to cut ties with all the negativities, all the negative people, and value yourself a little more. Because if you don't value yourself, you would not be able to cut off some people, you know, from your life, because you would feel like, you know, no, maybe they will get hurt or stuff like that. But what about the hurt that they bring into your life? So be mindful of that. You have to love yourself, and only then you will have the right people in your life who will love you the way you are. So yeah, that's pretty much it coming up for the month of March for the sign of Aquarius. If the reading resonates with you, or if it helped you in one way or the other, do like, subscribe, and share. And if you're willing to get a personal reading in this particular situation, reach out to me for that. Till I do the next reading for the Aquarians, take care. Bye-bye.